Hey, it's Ximos, and this is just a short little thing for Sea-ATL Games' website. I wrote a little article about like a small introduction to movement in TF2. It's very basic. It's not a tutorial on a specific movement. It's just kind of introducing the concepts that each class has. And so I figure Gravel Pit's probably a good place to show that off and kind of go class by class. But what the article starts out with is air strafing, so I can show an example of that here. So I'm gonna jump forward, but end up over there by air strafing. Shabam. So the way that works is, after I jump, I let go of the W key, press A or D, left or right, depending on which direction I want to be going or curving to, and also gently turning the mouse to kind of bring where I need to be. So you kind of start turning with your body with like the WASD movement. Sorry about that Facebook bloop. But then you also turn your mouse to sort of accelerate your facing direction. It all adds together to create a curved movement that you can help use to jump around corners and get dodgy and clever. Shit like that. In the article with the scout, I mentioned you could do tons of cool double jump tricks, and his weapons can also help with that. So you have the winger here, which makes each jump way higher, and you got the atomizer, which I failed to mention in the article, but this gives you a third jump, and so it's very strong because when you're engaging in combat, you kind of people are expecting your double jump to kind of happen, and then they try to measure that to kill you. But if you have a triple jump, you can redirect it for the low cost of 10 health. And combined with the winger, you got a whole lot of movement. But Scout doesn't have rocket jumping, but even without it, with weapons and stuff, he can get to places where he really shouldn't be getting to, like on top of this roof, which usually is generally only accessible by soldiers and demomen and very clever engineers. But even without using his extra weapons, he can get up here, which can help you get to where you need to. So that's Scout. Quick cut to a soldier. Hey, okay, so here we are, a soldier, my favorite class and my main class. You can rocket jump as him. That was a poor one, but so I can, instead of having to take this massive long walk up, I can simply go down and jump up. It's real good stuff. And you can jump up, of course, but you can also kind of jump forward. Try and move as quickly as you can. And the basics of ground rocket jumping sort of involve just a quick, if you slow down what I just did there, but if you do a quick like flick down and then jump and crouch at the same time, you'll get a good jump. But you'll go straight up, and that's a lot of the time you kind of want to just get to a location and not just walk up and be like, okay, here we go. To try to get into it, you want to just get there. So a lot of the time what I and many other people will do is instead of just aiming straight down, which is easy to do, you can turn behind and like just real quick, like a nice little flick, and then jump forward. It's a simple sort of, using geometry in your head, to kind of just be like, all right, ex explosion below me puts me up, so explosion slightly behind me should put me slightly forward the other direction. You can even pogo the rockets and stuff together. You can use walls and stuff to increase your speed. There's tons of reasons for this, and there's a tons of tutorials online. But now cut to Pyro. Hold up. Okay, we're back. Forgot about the map timer for this demonstration. But as I mentioned in the article, the Pyro does actually have some options when it comes to jumping. He has his power jack here, which, as you can tell, increases his speed. And while it might not seem that much, extra movement like that is incredibly key in a game like this. where you need to capture apparently really slowly. I forgot how long this point takes. But the Denner is kind of interesting because it's a flare gun that sort of gives up direct damage but enables you to manually detonate it. Obviously, it's called the detonator. It's that, you know, it's actually, it shoots fireworks, basically. But with that, you can, depending on where you hold your, when you decide to detonate, you can kind of detonate it right below you at a good time, which allows you to get a little bit of distance, a little bit of height, make occasionally jumps that you can't quite reach as pyro. I'm not very practiced in it, because, A, I'm not particularly good at pyro, you know, I'm decent enough, but I'm also not super interested in pyro, just the way he plays. That's just, like, you have to, it can give you a little bit of a boost. Not too much, but enough to make some gaps that you normally couldn't make. Like, can't make this jump, but I think with the detonator, you can. Yeah, so, there's small jumps you can make. I'm sure, you know, all well and good. I wonder if I can get back into the spawn. Because normally you can't make it back into the spawn as pyro. Ah, but you can with that, see? So, that's one use of the trick. So, I'll be back as Demo Man. Hey, back as Demo Man. Have, got my stickies up and ready to fly around like a champion. So, this isn't a 5CP map, so I can't demonstrate the Demoman's true speed. But if you just even one sticky like that, you notice for roughly about a third of my health, slightly less, you can fucking go. And get to exactly where you want to be and need to be. If you notice how I'm kind of, you know, going up, left, and directions in the air, that's the air strafing I talked about earlier. And also, Demoman, you know, he can use his pipes and pills and everything else. But it's not very often that you, it's only when you're using the Demo Knight sword option that you tend to need to use pills. Ah, god, tell Squid to stop, son of a bitch. Oh, well, anyway, so that's basically Demo Man. You know, it's not super complicated. You can sometimes survive with two stickies, but... Oh, shit. Okay, that won't be faster now that I blew it. And he captures the point. But, that's basically Demo Man. It's a little bit easier, but... Yeah. A lot of the time, you won't actually be sticky jumping in combat. You'll just be fighting. So, that's Demo Man. Cut to Heavy. Hey, back as Heavy. So, as Heavy, you get your Gru, which makes you take mini crits, so you're marked for death. But you go a lot faster than you do without it. And so you only gain access to any tricks and stages that let you, where making that kind of jump at that speed is useful. Otherwise, you know, you got Engineer here, who can build his gun up, and with the use of the Wrangler side weapon, you can boost yourself with your gun. Let's see here. You can use the bullets on pretty much any of the levels of the weapon, but you generally want to use the level 3 situation. Let's see. And so with the Rescue Ranger, which is a pretty popular weapon, you can jump as Engineer and then grab your gun with it and, you know, do some cool advanced movements. Beyond that, Medic, Sniper, they can surf, they can move, but otherwise, you know, they just move. That's all they can do. But, if you watch this, thanks for watching. If you also watched it on the Sea-ATL game site, that's super cool as well. That article is up this Monday from when this video is released / uploaded. So, check that out then. I'll update the description with it when that happens. And so thank you for watching again. Check that stuff out. And check out any further videos if you're interested. Have a good one.